I think Invoker too, because I also feel like Tusk is better with Invoker on his team than OD.
Yeah, because he's more killing gankable the lane. In mid, though.
Yeah, the lane kill.
The Invoker's a bit more
Yeah, but the Invoker's actually better for ganking with a Tusk than the OD is. That's what I mean. So I think like a Tusk Invoker can actually kill, whereas a Tusk OD might be able to kill, but it's not as likely.
Still pretty strong.
No, it's good, but I think like
Shards,
Sunstrike, Cold Snap,
up, Arcane Orb.
It's strong when the OD has more levels, like Invoker, maybe yeah. You have a much better probability of setting up.
Ooh.
Okay.
Secret
so they do play Ursa. Yeah, so they do play, yeah.
I didn't think they played Ursa. I haven't personally seen
that's why
before.
It felt strange, you know, the last game. So this game, they're gonna go for it. They're on the
it's
side.
Gonna be a puppy Ursa.
This is what you call it?
Sure, why not?
Nah, I'm just YOLOing. I think it's probably just Envy, but...
Yeah, Invoker for Fada still.
So now Secret have chosen Dire. They've chosen Ursa in the first phase, and what do you do now? Do you have to have strong lanes, or would you prefer strong team fights so you can contest the Roche?
Strong lanes and strong team fight basically accomplish the same thing against a lineup with an Ursa. If you can dominate the lanes hard enough, you don't necessarily need great 5v5. You can just take tier 1s and pressure the enemy team. You don't have to...
Which one do you think Liquid's better at?
I think they're better at controlling lanes, actually. I just don't think they had the proper heroes for it in the first game. I think Jerex is probably one of the best roamers, and if you give him a hero that he knows in and out, even though their win rate's not spectacular, it's still a comfort zone pick for them. And with having the Invoker already picked with it, I really like that combination, so... I think they could look to win lanes pretty hard here.
How about Vision? Like Beastmaster against Ursa?
Beastmaster with Ursa?
Against Ursa.
Oh,
oh
with
Ursa.
They have the first pick.
They have, yeah, so. Pick out of this phase.
There's the Engpan from Liquid.
So basically all the junglers have been removed. No jungling heals.
I think
X.
They would actually be... I think they would actually be more likely to go Tide in a situation than Beastmaster. Even
if
though
you are
I do
going
like
Tide,
Beastmaster.
Would you then not ban out Beastmaster if you are Team Secret right now?
Mind Control does play it.
Yeah, because Ursa is like kinda weaker against Beastmaster.
Yeah, you're gonna get kited a lot.
Boar's OP.
Okay, so they removed
I was thinking
Jared
Void or Phoenix might be a better ban.
Well, you can ban one or the other. They both kinda... It makes it less likely that they would pick Void, right? If you ban the Phoenix.
Mm-hmm. I think Liquid really like playing Phoenix when they have the Tusk, though. They've run this duo, I think. Most of the games they've had Tusk in, it's been accompanied by a Phoenix for Kuro, so...
Sigil and Egg.
Yeah. It's very strong.
What about Lone Druid? Any of these teams gonna go for Lone Druid?
It's bad.
Okay, it's bad. Never mind. JK.
I'm wondering which role Secret will pick now, if they'll pick a secondary support offlane or mid. I personally, I've said this 100 times this tournament, I really like Puck in this situation. They need the team fight. Catch
Puck
for Ursa.
Yeah. Plus Ursa is really, really good.
It's very difficult for Invoker Tusk to kill in mid. It has two counters, basically. You can dodge the snowball with phase shift, or you can just have an orb running and just outrun him. The matchup versus Invoker is fairly even. You might lose out slightly when Invoker gets levels, but until then you're fine.
Yeah, I like Puck.
It's very
like...
easy to gank 4, yeah. And it's very easy to secure Roshan with, so...
Do they play Puck, though?
Yeah, Weeha plays it.
I would like to see a Windranger, actually, for
Darkseer
Secret.
First. Windranger is good for the same reasons. It's less reliable teamfight, but it's hard gank mid.
With DS, it makes your idea better, though.
Dude, DS has really good synergy with Puck. Is there any Weeha hero we're missing out, we're forgetting here from it?
I mean, Ember. He does play Ember.
Windranger! No.
I don't like Ember versus
But actually, I might prefer a bit more towards Windranger compared to Puck, because when you have offlane Darkseer, maybe you want stronger cores, because Darkseer is not going to provide too much. And Ursa, you know, some games, if your game doesn't go so well, and Ursa is your lone carry, it might get too rough for the Ursa.
That's actually a bit of a rough spot, I think, for Liquid. Because picking Gyro into Ursa doesn't really seem super strong, and plus they've already taken away the Darkseer, so you don't, like...
And the Phoenix is banned.
And the Phoenix is banned. I actually feel like Secret have a huge advantage right now in the draft.
What does Liquid need to do to stop that advantage?
They need a safe laner who can pressure DS with a support that can actually be a little bit greedier. Because you already have the Tusk to control tempo, so I think they need something that's actually going to have a better time getting a farm priority,
I mean,
and also kill DS.
If you talk about doing well against Darkseid, there's always AM.
Yeah, you.
Yep. There's a couple of things speaking for an Oracle pick.
They actually have really bad tower killing right now on Secret.
That's the Beastmaster.
Teams don't really like Oracle so much, and I think its win rate is pretty poor, but this is the type of game where it's really good. It counters Darkstone in lane, you have the disarm against Ursa, you have the magic immunity against Lion. It's like, I mean, I guess if you look at Oracle that way, it always is going to look good, but I think this is one of those games where it's extra strong. And the weakness we've talked about with Oracle is that it's not very good at engaging and setting up fights and being a roaming support, but it's a little bit more static. But since they already have the Tusk accomplishing that role, they might be able to fit it in for Liquid. I just don't
really
know. Have they even played it this tournament?
This tournament maybe.
Yeah, Jarex played it. Jarex has played it.
I think
he played it once and they lost.
Yeah. Then it's just nope. Not gonna try it again.
0% win rate. We're done.
What about Secret? Oh,
that is not what I expected.
The old death.
Well, we talked about this before the series started, that it would be a high priority pick.
Yeah. They have to babysit that lane so hard, though. This is such a gankable hero against what Liquid have.
Team Secrets turn gonna. I mean, they're gonna have a lot of vision to scout the Rosh with the wolves and the hawk. I mean, at the same time, Secret has really good team fight to secure the Roshan, like for the Ursa. That's what you want to have. You want to have a lot of team fight when you are going to anticipate the enemy contesting the Rosh, which is so crucial for the Ursa, the first Roshan.
So are they going to go like Dazzle or Venge now for Secret?
Dazzle's really good here.
Yeah.
Armor against Lycan.
Both is really good. And Grave is very good for the Death Prophet.
Yeah. What's going to happen with this is that Liquid will try to engage fights by roaring DP and just running her down.
What? Secret are gonna pick Oracle.
I like Shaker more.
Right? Because they can take Oracle away from Liquid if it's that good of a pick.
Oh.
And it still accomplishes the same thing.
That's
and then
true.
Liquid can't get sustained.
I don't know if Puppy plays it. But...
Show me Oracle.
He plays everything. We saw him play Earth Spirit yesterday.
Doesn't Pyladai play the hero in the team? Like Oracle? I remember Pyladai.
Oh, yeah. They just put him. I'm just so locked with Pi playing Lion.
Yeah.
But Puppy actually plays a really good Lion too. I think Puppy might be considering Shaker. Maybe it's a little bit too greedy, but it's just one of the picks he has gone to, and all
it's
of
really
his heroes
have
been banned. It's good against Tusk. It's
how about a curveball?
Pretty good against Lion.
Curveball of Ursa still being not an
Puppy
end
Ursa.
Here.
Dude, if I called that, I would be the panel
You'd
god.
You'd be legend. Yes. I mean, that is a pretty big curveball, to be honest, but.
I think
Puppy is known for jungling everything. But...
Yeah.
Doom jungle, okay.
Let's go.
Doom plus Doxia offlane?
That is not really Doom gaming.
Like what else? What else can jungle? Like what else does he play like jungle?
Plays SP, but
he plays everything jungle. He just play Iron Talon, dude.
Oh, okay, sure.
Winter Wyvern.
Oh, okay, that's different. I like it though.
It's good D push.
I forgot about that hero.
You can defend towers against Lycan. Oh. Core Embrace versus Lycan.
Good with Darkseer. Yeah.
It's a really big weakness actually for Liquid that a lot of their damage is physical.
Yeah, when you mentioned good with Darkseer, like how long that I have not seen this combination, Darkseer plus Wyvern. You're so good in during TI.
It's also better in the sense that it has D push, whereas Oracle and Venge both kind of lack in that department. And they already could secure Roshan with just Ursa. They don't need another hero to help with that.
Oh!
Okay.
Quick
predictions. I want to hear just a team named No Explanation. Sinnerin first. Go.
No explanation.
Liquid. Secret.
Liquid.
Secret.
Okay, even split. Let's hear what our commentators have to say. It is over to Capitalist and Blitz in the arena.
Team Liquid, they already had the hard task of facing up against Team Secret, already trounced them in the upper bracket finals. Now they're one game down in the grand finals, and they're facing up against one of their signature heroes. Blitz, what do you make of the Ursa being prioritized so heavily in the draft?
I think this is just the best of five meta that's developing. Mm-hmm. They know that Liquid want to go to it if they can. They have the second pick. They figured it's really strong. We're on Dire side. This kind of coincides pretty well, but...
So it serves as both a strong pickup for Team Secret on Dire, but it's also a way to block it away from Team Liquid.
Yes.
I like that idea. What do you think of the last picks, the supports? Supports who have not been really seen a whole lot of success rate lately. Winter Wyvern as well as Oracle.
I think Winter Wyvern is an interesting hero. It does pretty well against heroes with summons in general, and the Cold Embrace is quite good this game. Owen mentioned it quite often. The Splinter Blast is really good as a D push spell too. The thing I'm a little bit concerned about is teams still feel a little bit uncomfortable playing around the Winter's Curse, and the fact that you can't deal damage during it. You've got to play around that spell pretty well, and the Oracle, I think Jerix is pretty comfortable with. Seen him play it in the past in other matches too, and it does work really well against the Darkseer.
Yeah, it does just dispel away that Ion Shell early on in lane, so that'll definitely help out the Lycan, but we're also talking about the disarm against the Ursa, and they are rather single-target focused at times, so even a well-timed False Promise can turn the pace of this fight for Team Liquid. Definitely feels like the easier support to utilize, especially since the Winter Wyvern is paired up with a Death Prophet, a hero that kind of has some uncontrollable damage. You may lose some of that exorcism time. Yep. With the Winter's Curse.
And at bottom, Secret are going to get control of this rune.
They're gonna try
they
and
actually
catch...
get both of them.
Oh, they can get the Ice Shards there, but there's no follow-up. So both Battle Runes being picked up by Team Secret.
Huge advantage so far, especially since the Death Prophet already does really well against the Invoker. The mm-hmm. Spirit Siphon makes it so that the Invoker simply can't trade. You would think that with Cold Snap plus your four Spirits you could, but Spirit Siphon's insane. Plus, Puffy's going to be here with the Arctic Burn level 1, make life a little bit hard. We saw in the last game, Puffy primarily focused on the offlane, which I thought was a brilliant decision. This time around, he's going to make sure that we have the best possible start.
Yeah, they really know how to set these lanes out right. What do you think about Misery now that he no longer has Puppy supporting him in the bottom lane? It's actually going to be full-time jungling to start with.
You almost never want to just sack a Darkseer if you're Team Secret. And any team in general, that was the one thing that I always heard from pros. Never let a Darkseer just get sacked. You have to allow this hero to get some farm to be useful in the game. He's not just Tidehunter where, you know, you blink Ravage, you get your ability off great. You need a lot of items and abilities to back yourself up. Because you want to be the frontliner for your team when you walk in and vacuum wall.
Do you think that this is just directly in response to an Oracle who's able to purge away that Ion Shell, and meaning the Darkseer may not actually get any farm in lane?
Yeah, absolutely. Misery could go down there, but for what point? You're not going to get anything out of the lane. You're simply just going to Ion Shell two creeps. They're both going to get purged off, and you're going to say, why didn't I just jungle in the beginning anyways?
Mm-hmm.
But Misery? This is going to open up some room for the two supports.
He ends up dying to the neutrals and didn't actually buy anything. That was not intentional. He could have bought the Sage's Mask to start completing that Soul Ring. So that was actually a bit of an error by him. So he just wanted to clear through that last hard camp creep and then probably would have actually denied himself via the neutrals after he bought the Sage's Mask.
Yeah. And I'm waiting for Liquid to move this Tusk around the map. Just because there is no Darkseer here, you want to try to apply pressure to this Death Prophet if you possibly can, especially since Puppy's mirroring movements, but he's going to pick up the Invis rune, check top himself, see where the Beastmaster is, but Mind Control is doing the exact same thing, albeit a little bit slower.
Yeah, obviously Beastmaster is never going to be as fast as Ion Shell Darkseer, who's able to utilize stacks. Looks like Puppy wants to maybe try and catch the Courier out before that 3-minute marker. But if he doesn't see it, he'll probably rotate in the jungle, see if he can get some harassment onto Mind Control.
Yeah, he's waiting quite a long time for it, but nobody from Liquid using it just yet, and he's just going to make his way back around.
Rather unfortunate timing, because the Golden OD Courier starts waddling its way to mid now.
He's just going to Arctic Burn a few more hits on Fada from the high ground. Even pulling the creep away, this is not what he wants to do.
A bit of bad timing here. Liquid once again. Not really rotating one of their supports into the mid lane a whole lot. This time around, they do have a roamer. It's just Jerix isn't playing it because, as you said, Jerix feels more comfortable with the Oracle than Kuro probably does.
Yeah, we've seen Kuroki play the Tusk earlier in the tournament too, and it was fine, but they really want Jerix, if possible, not on this lane support role, but something that can get a little bit more active. And looks like Wii is, once again in this game, going to have a pretty decent time in the mid lane, but Fada is, despite the pressure from this Winter Wyvern, is winning in the CS.
Purging off that Ion Shell, Misery's got another one in 3 more seconds. They're going to try and cut the creep wave, put some more pressure on that tower with the next creep wave coming in. I like this just to be able to force the Darkseer back into lane.
It's not just that, it's that Puppy's level 1. He doesn't have any levels of the Splinter Blast, and he can't really support or save with the Cold Embrace either, and so this tower should be relatively free for Liquid. Looks like Secret are posturing, but...
Yeah, they're actually going to have a TP in. They really want to get this deny in the tier 1, and they should be able to get it.
Yeah, this is the best possible result for them, is Misery's going to pick up some levels, Puppy's going to get his level 2, they get the deny. Liquid really rely on the Tower Gold as well for both their supports.
At some point, does Mutumba Man start going full-time jungle to open up some space for one of his supports, and if so, which one is it?
I'd say he probably leaves it for the Oracle to get the quick level 6. This is the hero that they want to have a little bit more utility if possible.
Mm-hmm.
And he's only level 4 right now, though. I think going to the jungle is a little bit premature.
Yeah, yeah. Usually not seen until you at least have the mask and maybe level 5 or 6.
Yeah, the thing that scares me right now is that because of this free lane at top, Eternal Envy is getting absolute free farm out of this top lane. And more importantly than that, because both supports are rotating around the map, he's gotten free experience. And we saw Liquid, they committed both their supports to staying at bottom. So this Lycan is actually pretty far behind in levels.
It's a bit surprising to me that Mind Control actually TP's in to continue jungling despite the top lane pushing out. Eternal Envy doesn't even have an early set of phase boots, so it's not like there's that gigantic movement speed advantage they Ursa should have over Mind Control.
Yeah, right now, the Darkseer is also going to get a lot more utility out of the jungle. He's already got the Soul Ring and is level 5. Mind Control's desperately trying to farm up, but it's hard to keep up with a DS who eventually should just go down bottom again if the Oracle decides to try to rotate around.
Seems like Misery's going to do that.
Yeah, Kuro's...
right now, Kuro gets some aggressive vision around the Roshan pit.
I think they spotted that, though.
Yeah, they did.
With the Observer Ward that they still have. So yeah. That's a lot of value.
So they should be able to counter it in due time.
Yeah, they're even going to place a tower ward right behind the tower. And Puppy's pinging out. They want to try to secure this top rune for anybody, really. Mind Control's going to make his way up there, but this would be a pretty ambitious kill for them.
Puppy should be able to fly away with the Arctic Burn.
He's getting slowed down
pretty
badly, but just makes it over to the ridge.
So that should be pretty obvious, though, that Liquid's movements were scouted with the way that Weehaw played that super safe, put himself on the far left-hand side away from the two supports who are underneath that tower. And they actually will be able to get both wards here. So they should know about that bottom ward, and they just caught the mid ward as well.
Yeah, as long as they don't forget about it. And the Tusk is immediately going to TP up to top. He knows that their rotation has been spotted. Realizes there's no point in trying to help out this mid gank anymore.
Secret with just some really solid defense of these tier 1 towers so far. I mean, they got the deny in the bottom one. They're making sure that the ganks on mid aren't successful while still making sure the tier 1 tower stays alive.
This passive stop by them has been really successful. They're just holding the line right now. When it comes to net worth, it is in Liquid's favor, obviously, because of the tower, but XP is a little bit towards Secret. They spaced out things a little bit better.
Would you say that this is kind of the signature style of Secret, a lot more passive, and that they've found a way to fit it into this kind of meta?
Yeah, I think it's more they just wait for teams to make mistakes against them.
Mm-hmm.
Like, Secret wants you to feel antsy. This is something I've noticed in all their games, is that even though they might not always have the cleanest early game, is they wait for you to slip up, make mistakes, because they have the superior late game they can play behind and kind of wait. That's why you saw Liquid, like, they took bad fight after bad fight, because they just had to. They were forced into it. And in this game, Secret are just saying, okay, we're getting a lot of levels on Envy, he's got absolute free farm, nobody's been in his lane. Our Death Prophet's doing okay, our Darkseer will farm a little bit faster than this Beastmaster. We can hold this line, on top of the fact that we're dire, we've got the Roshan advantage too. There's a lot of things that work out for them.
Yeah, it seems like they could just continue this almost indefinitely until it's time for Eternal Envy to rotate into that Roshan pit.
So yeah.
Maybe that's where Liquid can gain some ground back, but we've already seen with that ward that was placed out earlier from Secret scouting some of those support rotations, they should know what a priority
this three-man
is
rotation. As Eternal Envy even gets involved, they want to surge the Darkseer forward, but immediately going to get out as Puppy and Kuro have a little bit of time to themselves at the top, but Matama Man is going to see some space out of this, and Fada looks like he even wanted to send the Forge Spirit into the Roshan pit just to see if anything nefarious was about, but the Hawk is already there.
So Eternal Envy, in the meantime, is just going to farm up some Ancients until they see that opening on the mid lane.
Yeah, and that's why Fada's just playing really far back. And Jerex has even gotten involved here, but they're just immediately going to... Misery's going to TP out bottom. This Ursa should be spotted by now, yep. The ward sees him. And they might even... Oh, they don't have another smoke for this.
Once again, it's one of those kind of smoke scenarios where Liquid play really safe on their safe lane in Matumba Man.
Yeah.
Just playing
oh, they're
going to
go for Puppy, 100%.
They are going to be able to dive him out here. Where's the Sunstrike? Apparently they felt that wasn't going to be enough damage, so they didn't even go for it. TPs are canceled. They still have to play careful in this mid lane without the rotations. Fada is still
They see the Lion and the Ursa, though.
They're still going to be able to run down Puppy. This time around, the Sunstrike will land. A TP comes out from the Ursa, but it's obviously too late. That'll be first blood to Liquid.
And with the Ursa TPing up there, and they know the two canceled TPs, Liquid have full vision, Pylite Die.
And now they can keep forward down the middle lane. Pylite Die is going to come in from the side. They put some pressure on Weeha and force Pi to show himself.
Yeah, they want to try to take down this mid tower if they can because of the force rotations of Team Secret. Really well done by Liquid. They're not forcing aggression. And their Beastmaster almost has his Necrobook 1. He's already picked up both components that he needs, and Matama Man has sneaked his way into the Roche Pit 2. He's got the Medallion. They know there's no Ward Vision down here. It's up to Misery to actually check this for Team Secret.
This is such a dangerous proposition, though, to actually try and go for Roshan against an Ursa team by yourself.
Yeah, everybody started rotating over from Secret.
So he'll go back to doing jungling.
They just want to get it before Eternal Envy does. It limits the Ursa's offensive potential a lot, because this hero does rely on being able to get a free Aegis.
Now, if Liquid can actually get a pickoff in the mid lane, they can actually transition this into an early Roshan. They're going to try and go for this dive. The Sunstrike will be able to block Weeha, but the TPs are coming in. But Tama Man's already popped the ultimate. Looks like they're going to go for Fadi here, but he managed to get saved by the Oracle. Some of that damage is going to come out of Misery. Puppy, they're going to be able to turn for him. He's already thrown out that Cold Embrace. He'll be surrounded by the Wolves. Fadi is the one victim there from Liquid who will end up going down. But Misery may still lose his life here. They're holding onto the snowball from Curl. It's going to be thrown out in a second here to stall up Misery as best as possible. They have the Ice Shards to be able to block him in.
The
Wolves
and the Medallion are going to be enough.
He's going to be dying for this one. The Healing Salve keeps him alive, and they do manage to get Misery. That is a 1-for-4 exchange, plus they got the Tier 1 tower. A beautiful fight for Team Liquid.
That was about as good as it gets. You did lose your Invoker if you're in Liquid, but you don't really care. Mind Control continues to get space. You didn't even have to do it with your main initiating hero. On top of that, Liquid got so much experience in farm on both their supports. The mid lane is now opened up. The bottom lane is now opened up. This gives them a lot of opportunities to go for the Roshan if they want to.
We have a Rod of Atos built on Fada's Invoker, but bottom lane is where Kuro's being chased by Eternal Envy. He's not going to be able to catch, though. Just takes the 90 gold from the Sigil, and they're actually going to try and... Okay, maybe not.
I think it's a little bit ambitious for them to immediately go for it, but they have to deal with this top tower, too. Mind Control's going to just pick up all this farm by himself. They're already pinging him out, but they've got to make the decision soon, as this Tier 1 tower is going to fall for absolutely nothing.
Yeah, Liquid know they are in a great position just control-wise. That Ursa is not going to be able to take Roshan without them noticing, so they're just hard-pressuring top lane until Secret are forced into either going for Roshan and having some sort of crazy 5-versus-5 Roshan pit, or Liquid start gaining some ground after a little bit of a bad start in the laning phase.
You notice that Eternal Envy is hanging around almost exclusively around this Roshan pit. They know that the pace of the game really relies on them to be able to get this, and this is why they're predominantly playing here.
The snowball coming in. He's on the wrong side of the Ice Shard too. Jarek's going to come in from the side. He does have his ultimate, but he chooses not to use it on Kuro, especially since it's being controlled up by the Winter Wyvern. Now they're going to be able to come in with Fada, but is the damage actually going to be enough? Eternal Envy's being dazed up once again by the Winter Wyvern while Jarek stays himself. They're going for Weeha instead, but the damage is too much. Weeha's going to be able to actually chase away the Lycan, and now Fada, he's in too deep against two, and there comes a pause as Liquid crash at just the wrong moment.
And they really needed the Beastmaster there for that engagement as everybody from Secret rotated in. For Liquid, though, at worst, it'll be a 3-for-3 exchange, but Secret are going to be pretty happy with that as their mid laner got a lot out of this.
And Fada should be dying now as the silence. The Rod of Atos is actually keeping Weeha from being able to chase him down, but Misery is still able to help get the kill.
And the Wolves are on top of Wee, but immediately going to pop that wand, and he should be just fine. As the top tower is getting pushed out, and if Mind Control had that first level of Necrobook, might have been able to do even more damage to this, but... Although the fight recap heavily benefits from Secret.
It definitely could have been a lot worse. If that Ursa had not died, they would have been able to go Roshan. They've now got the mech, plus their level 6s on some of their supports, which was missing earlier on. Pylite Eye, as well as the Winter Wyvern. Earlier when they were trying to maybe go for the Roshan, it was the limit of those supports that kind of kept them back from being able to take it.
Yeah, that was huge from Weeha too. His game was a little bit stunted, but he's going to pick up drums now, catching up in farm. And this is a hero that just relies on being ahead in net worth at all times. You can't be under farm with Death Prophet. You need some sort of tank items.
and otherwise you're in danger of just being focused out by Liquid, right?
Yeah,
that's,
exactly.
That's going to be all your damage.
You never want to be behind. Like, you want the levels, you want to be able to be the frontliner for your team. This Ursa you saw, even with the Cold Embrace, goes down pretty quickly. They can't afford for him to...
This ward game has been beautiful back and forth. We saw the way the Team Seeker were able to take early control thanks to their bottom lane wards. Spotted out two different wards being placed out by Liquid, but yeah. Now Liquid managed to take away.
He breaks the smoke. They're going to know
that
now for sure.
That is a full reveal. Team Liquid will just sit on the high ground and wait for Secret to make their move.
Secret have to be so excited about that one.
He's spotted out here, turns around, goes to the Hex, but immediately that's taken off by the Oracle. A nice two-man silence is actually going to prevent some aggression, but Pilot Eyes still going to dive the wall, smoke the Sun Strike. Liquid take a kill against Team Secret while committing no heroes whatsoever.
They're
and now they're actually
going
to go to the Matumba Band. Oh, what a win this race for Puppy! Turns that one right around against Jarek, trying to blow him up. The snowball comes up through. Matumba Band still healthy, though, trying to stay ahead of Eternal Envy. Well, going for the zombie, these Squisher heroes get a little bit too close, though. Eternal Envy starts nabbing onto him. Pearl, he's not going to be escaping. Oh, what a great eye charge, but still, he's locked inside the trees, only buying himself time, not actually saving his life. But as you said, Mind Control has pushed out the top lane in Tier 2. Tier 3, he gets Puppy as well. Mind Control's gonna look for the escape now against Pilot Eye, and he's gonna turn and go for the Primal Roar. They're actually gonna be able to Sunstrike. Pilot Eye's down! Mind Control now
they don't have the vacuum
casually.
Anymore.
Oh my god! The offlaner Team Liquid shows up big at the perfect time because Secret will get Roshan number one for themselves. They had a play like that, had to have it.
They're both gonna go down. Secret, fortunately for them, they're gonna be able to pick up this Roshan that they desperately needed, but Liquid look like they want to try to make an attempt.
But
Weehawk doesn't
have
the ghost.
Health, though. That is so dangerous. They do have the disarm, but the silence on to Jarek. They now have Curl and
he's
going to be able to kite around Eternal Levy. He's got nothing here. Jarek's on the bottom side. He's actually saved himself. They've taken away the Aegis while Weehawk looks to be able to chase down Jarek. The ultimate wears out, but he's still not dead. Back over to Eternal Levy, where he's surrounded by three. He obviously has no hope. Team Liquid, they bait Secret in. They win the fight. They'll take now. Where are they going to go? Middle lane, tier 2, perhaps?
And this hero that's been ignored for so long, this Mind Control Beastmaster, almost already has Necrobook 3. It's going to coincide really nicely with the timing of Matumba Man's, because they're just racking up the farm right now, and it's going to be really difficult for Secret to push this out, even with the Splinter Blast against the double Forge Spirit, double Necrobook setup from Team Liquid. Is they set their sights on this bottom tier 2 tower. They know that Weehawk doesn't have his ultimate quite yet, and with Eternal Envy down without the Aegis, I doubt they want to take this fight, especially without a Blink Dagger on them.
And now this looks like the same thing that you said for Eternal Envy in game number 1, where they feel like Liquid, they're in enough control this game, they can go back for the Midas, perhaps, on Invoker?
Yeah, I think this is the setup that we saw out of Fada yesterday, too, where he wants to make sure that he gets some control with the Rod of Atos, and we saw how effective it was in the fight when they were able to take out Pylite Dye in the beginning of this.
Right.
This Lion is really crucial to Team Secret, which is why they keep picking a top 2. They want Pylite Dye to be as effective as possible in fights, but Fada, he wants to make sure he doesn't get too far behind the other cores. And Jarex is gonna
he's gonna be the one
jungle.
Taking the smoke. It looks like Eternal Envy smoke
is
popped.
I think they
and
see him.
Jarex is trying to get back to the tier 2 tower. Puppy will be able to slow him down though. Jarex should be dying here. The silence controls him long enough. Maybe he can get off while his promise, but no, it's just too fast. So Secret get that quick support kill and we'll turn it into a tier 1 tower.
I don't think
but
they can.
Liquid, they're in a much better position. They've lost a support. Who cares? They're pushing out top and middle lane.
Yeah, they've got to deal with this before they do anything, and they've got to pick their poison. We either go for mid or we go for top as Team Secret. Puppy's got to tell his team, you guys have to get back here right now.
They're going to start mass keeping into the middle lane. They're going to pop Matumba Man's ultimate to be able to make sure he has a clean escape, and Kuro's already one step ahead.
And Puppy's pinging top. He's saying, guys, we've got to deal with this Beastmaster.
Yeah, Puppy's already dealing with it. He's dealing with it all right. He's actually end up going down to sack himself to keep some of that tier 3 tower damage alive. Mind Control is going to be chased down by Weehawk. Pylite Dye though, so it's well worth the sacrifice of Puppy.
Yeah, Liquid managed to pick up both the tier 2.
Oh god, the courier! Oh no! That was a Blink Dagger! Tragedy strikes for Team Secret, as that was one of the items they really needed to keep the pace of this game.
For a full 3 minutes, they're gonna have to fight without it. And Puppy, he's gotta gather his troops and say, guys, we're just making too many errors around the map right now. Secret are being ragdolled.
torn apart the map left and right. We've got Necrobook 3 on Beastmaster, Necrobook 2 now on Matumba Man's Lycan. Items flowing in for Liquid all over the place. They're even going to have a mech soon on Jerix. He's made a great recovery from that very stunted tri-lane scenario they were in.
Yeah, the top two net worths in the game, both Liquid cores.
How do you play this now as Secret in order to get control back? Can you actually wait the full 3 minutes for that blink deck?
I almost think you have to right now. The things that have gone so well for Secret in the past games was that Pylai Dai was able to get a lot of space because of the space that Puppy was able to create for the other lanes. Then they allow Pi to kind of just play his own game. But in this one, Liquid are kind of just putting their foot down and saying, we're going to attack you from every single angle. Go for the Roshan, then we'll push your tier 2 atop. Now they've almost got that open tower, the tier 3. And Secret, they've just got to stick and move. Play as fast as they can. Decide on whether or not they're going to defend top or mid. And do it a little bit quicker.
I thought for a second Liquid were going to go for a four-man smoke, but that isn't actually the case. They're just team clearing through their jungle. Since Secret is off map, they're perhaps afraid of a five-man smoke from the enemy.
Yeah, this Beastmaster with the Necrobook 3, he got it like 17 minutes into the game, can pretty much kill anybody by himself. Maybe Eternal Envy he'd struggle with, but with the boar he could most likely get the kite going.
I really like the solo smoke from him, where he's centering up. He knows, yeah, as you said, that he can kill anybody he comes across. So he's actually avoiding the vision right now of Team Secret. Unfortunately for him, all five are bottom lane. I think he's expecting a Liquid push, but it's just a feint. Liquid don't actually want to go for that. They're content with continuing farming efficiency.
And Team Secret are gathered completely as five in this bottom lane. They want to make sure that nobody gets caught off by that Beastmaster because he has that solo kill potential. And Eternal Envy, they must wait for the Blink Dagger. There's not a really good way for him to gap close against heroes like the Invoker and the Lycan otherwise.
Once again, the low net worth at 20 minutes. Do tell about the early leads that either team has been able to gain. Still though, Team Secret have the opportunity to, once they had that Blink Dagger, perhaps thinking about recontrolling this game with Roshan number 2.
Yeah, and both Ward Vision.
They just have to dodge Liquid's traps.
Liquid have that ward in mid, but Secret, they've also got their own ward in the jungle that's been completely unspotted. That's seeing all the rotations from Team Liquid, but Secret might not really be able to do much about this as Liquid continue to split up the map. They've got the Necro 3 on both their cores, so the split push game can begin.
Oh, Jerix, he's going to be run down here. He was trying to get an aggressive ward up, but now we should know that there's a ward of Secret sitting there. They're actually going to be able to pop Jerix, almost silenced up a little bit longer, and he won't be able to get off that false promise. Now the Winter's Curse laid out, but oh, that was a mistake, only catching creeps. It's Weeha hoping to be able to fight this one, and now still pops a Ghost Scepter just as a Primal Roar, but still, there's enough magic damage to be able to threaten him. Now Eternal Envy comes in, finally picking up that Blink Dagger and blows up.
They need to kill Weeha.
They're going to be able to actually go for Weeha as soon as the Yule Scepter is down, but it may not be enough. The Deafening Blast is back in Liquid. They're just being run down now. Mind Control is going to be next one up. He tries to go for the TP out, but damage is too much. Eternal Envy able to finish him off. Matumba Man gets the kill in the end with the Necronomicon against Weeha, but Secret very happy with that exchange.
This Death Prophet stayed alive for so long. It allowed Ursa to be able to do whatever he wanted in this engagement. They had to pop the roar for it, but the cold embrace from Puppy proving to be too much. The Invoker just decided, oh, he's already dead after the roar. But they didn't quite have enough damage, and that was Secret wasting the Winter's Curse and the Darkseer Vacuum too. But Weeha played that fight so well, itemizing entirely defensively.
Yeah, the Ghost Scepter choice and being able to pop it just ahead of that Primal Roar use saved him so much damage.
That's going to give Secret a lot more control in this game. XP plummeting sharply. Net worth going in a similar situation. Liquid still have a lot of map control, but they wanted to be able to parlay that fight into going for the high ground. Did not expect to lose that one that badly. As Liquid, they're going to have to reset the game.
And with that, Secret will have some fresh items coming in. They've got 3k on Eternal Envy. What's his next item?
He could decide to go for the Aghanim Scepter that we've seen so popular on CTY and RTZ.
Particularly against Beastmasters, it feels quite strong.
Yeah, I don't actually think he lacks for Disable too much, but if he does, going for the Basher isn't a bad idea either. I do like the idea of the Aghanims though. I think it's kind of cool. BKB is also an option.
We has the point booster. Be able to go for the Octarine Core. They know that last fight was godsend for them, but they need more. Unfortunately for them, a Lycan Wolf just spotted out this smoke, and Kuro knows it's coming. He's quick on the retreat, trying to stay ahead of Weeha, but he'll catch up eventually with the old scepter. The rest of his team is sitting on the side. They've got the False Promise ready to go. Kuro is not actually, yes, he is going to be saved by the False Promise, but now the Wicked Curse comes in. They are going to be able to fall by control. Against them now. The ice wall laid out his beautiful position. Pylai dies almost immediately.
Oh, that's holding ice!
Another save from Poppy. He has to deal with the wolves up now as he's being chopped away. Slowly but surely, but the TP will complete just in time. Weeha has Necronomicons all over him, but it doesn't matter. Too liquid. Vada. Oh, this is dangerous. He actually wants to go for the Sun Strike. A little bit of Soul Suck, and we'll
they have the damage.
The damage is in again. Eternal Envy finishes him off as Vada was playing the chicken game there with Secrets. But now, with both Weeha as well as Yersa alive, they can take Roshan number two. Everything Secret needed to happen has happened. They're back in this game 100%.
I don't even think they're back. I think they're starting to get ahead now. With the type of lineup that they have, this Weeha Death Prophet is doing way too much for Team Secret right now. They know he's a primary damage dealer, but Liquid can't really do anything about it. With the Cold Embrace to back him up, the physical damage lineup that Liquid have just isn't being very successful in Secret. This Winter Wyvern pick, I was skeptical at first, but it's paid off for them so well.
Most certainly has the Buckler. Actually turning into a mech here, obviously, as Misery has a completed Guardian Greaves, so it's not really needed. Do you like the idea of this Veil of Discord?
I think it's a pretty good plan, just because you already do have a lot of nuke damage. But Ursa does have the Aghanim Scepter. And with that Aegis too, he is so strong. All the farm that this Beastmaster once had, it's gone down the drain.
Really seeing the power of this Winter Wyvern against these Necronomicon users.
The Winter Wyvern has been so effective for them. Liquid, I think, have not hit their timing window with the double Necronomicon either.
No, certainly not. Now they're very rapidly falling behind. They do have the Aghanims on the Invoker. Still need to complete this mech that should have been picked up so much earlier for Jerix, but bad fight after bad fight has stalled him up dramatically.
Yeah, he's going to finish it, though. And I don't know how much of a difference it's going to make, though. As Team Secret, they are so comfortable right now. They're in their element.
Is it smoke time? They've got one on Puppy. They're letting Eternal Envy and Weeha push out the lanes for now.
Secret, at some point you want to be able to make use of the Aegis. Start to pressure out some of these tier 1 towers that they can still go through. Which tells you how precarious the lead was for Team Liquid. Like, it's already shifted downwards and Secret can still take two very easy tier 1 towers.
Veil Discord in. Is there anything else that Secret need to wait on before they force a fight? They still have the Aegis, so it seems like they should have the incentive to do so.
They're just making sure to push out all their lanes before they just go for it.
Right.
And Pylai Dai now has the Ghost Scepter too. We saw how effective one Ghost Scepter was. And
does this mean you need a Diffusal Blade picked up by someone?
Maybe.
I mean, they do have Fortune's End, but not the fastest ability in the world.
Yeah. It also means that Liquid have to get the jumps in the fights. And they might have to start focusing down this Puppy Winter Wyvern. That Cold Embrace again. Helping out so much, and they're immediately going to go for the smoke, and this is the play, especially when you've got the Aegis. The first time they did it resulted in an absolute team wipe of Team Liquid, and
I like this.
They want this again.
Eternal Envy has picked up Boots of Travels. They're coming out to him now, but in the meantime, he's actually going to show himself at this bottom lane while his team goes for the fight.
Yeah.
So it may actually lure Liquid into a false sense of security.
They know that Wii is a strong enough frontliner, and the mid wave is pushing in too. So Envy believes that he can get there in time. And he's immediately going to start TPing Matumba Man.
He knows he can have him surrounded in the middle lane. Matumba Man, he needs to be able to get off this BKB just in time. Oracle even popping that ultimate. They're going to turn. Who are they going for? Puppy is going to be identified as the first target.
Misery's gonna go down. Misery's gonna be blown up by the Sunstrike. The Puppies, Cold and Brain's gonna run out eventually, but it gets him in Winter's Curse! A beautiful one that blows up Pearl all by itself, a missed up from Pylon Dive, and it gets on the finger of Death on Fauna. They need to be able to control him, but Cold Snap is actually stalling up, and Turtle Levy with an Ice Charge! Pearl! He's making sure Turtle Levy's just gonna be kited around in this fight. He still managed to get onto Jarek, still popping the enrage, and he will be able to catch up until the disarm. Snowball stun. Oh my god, is Turtle Levy not gonna get anything out of this first life? He isn't! Now, he's way too deep behind this tier 1 tower, underneath an ice wall immediately, he managed to get the blink forward. Mind Control will be able to get them the vision though, once again a cold snap comes through, Ice Shark blocking out a Turtle Levy, he knows he has to turn and fight for the Walrus Punch, it's making things difficult. Where's the sun? Did he not have one in Snowball? Oh, there's a tornado, stopping a Turtle Levy from escaping, and they will finish him off. Team Secret, they thought they had the advantage in that fight, but Team Liquid responded beautifully, blowing up Misery, while at the same time, Matumba Man addressed Puffy right away. Even with the Winter's Curse still going off, he put the pressure on him to make sure that he had to Cold Embrace first, stalling out that reactive fight.
And that was the best decision by Crow in this entire game for him to go for the buyback. Understands that his team needs the extra control factor. The scary thing for Liquid, though, is that that Ursa, without the buyback from the Tusk, might have been enough to just 1v2. And he was really damn close to it, but Secret, they still get the Lycan kill. Unfortunately, they weren't able to pick up the mid tower with the Aegis. But Liquid aren't going to be able to force out any buybacks, and Secret are still kind of in an okay position. The XP lead is still in their favor, and Misery's going to actually not be able to deny that top tower. Spada gets the last hit on it. But this Roshan fight, the next one, that'll be the Aegis and Cheese. If they could get a Cheese up on Weeha.
Yo, that would be such a huge upgrade, especially with the Octarini he already has. It would make Team Liquid popping Wii almost an impossible task.
They struggle so hard to kill him already, Cap.
Yeah. Every single time Puppy has been there with the Cold Embraces when Weeha has been initiated on first.
Dangerous amount of teamfight from Secret. As Liquid, they did have the early control. Their net worth lead looked like it was just going to skyrocket at one point, but that initial encounter where they just couldn't burst down the Death Prophet cost them so much.
So Mind Control has a Blink Dagger. Where do we go from here with 2k gold?
They already have the Vlads on the Lycan. Maybe even he gets a Ghost Scepter. I think everybody in this game just...
just mass Ghost Scepters all around?
Yeah, I mean, if you look at it, the Ghost can't hit you from DP.
What about him? Oh, he's actually going to go for Misery with a Sunstrike. They should have enough extra damage to be able to kill him. Now the question is, can Mind Control actually get out? He doesn't have a TP, so that seems unlikely. Eternal Envy gobbles him up.
Yeah, there's no Boar there either to slow him down. And he is going to lose all of his mana, but Liquid, they're making their way up. But Tumba Man's even popped the ultimate, but with the ward down, this is going to be incredibly hard for them. Even to commit the Ghost.
Yeah, he uses that Exorcism before Liquid actually get there for the fight. And so it's a quick disengage by the boys in blue.
Is Roshan going to be up in time?
If
Crow recognizes, he's like, he could tell his team, we can go for the Roshan if they want.
Well, tier 1 tower is definitely forfeit here.
Yeah. Puppy has to tell his team, back up, it's okay that we committed the ghosts, reset the fight, and make sure nothing bad comes out of it. You just have to get out of there as a team if you're Secret.
The gem, actually, I'm not sure if we mentioned that one, but Misery had a gem. And that was stolen away in the previous fight. So Kuro's walking around with that one now.
Liquid immediately smoke up. They know with the ghost down, this is going to be one of their better opportunities to engage. Secret. The Octarine Core is on the Death Prophet, so it's going to be back up in 45
seconds.
And they
actually kill Weeha here. Puppy, he's coming in from the right-hand side. The Ghost Scepter buys him some time, but the Deputy Class wants to beat it. It is enough to kill Weeha. The Winter's Curse comes in big on the Fada. It's Fada control, Pylon Knight. He balls up Jarek. Make sure there's no false promise here, but Fada, he's actually getting away from this a little bit. Misery stops him. No, the tornado. He buys him more time. Fada gets away, and Matumba Man turns against the Tunnel Levy. He's surrounded by an army of Necronomicon. A long-range snowball. Kuro wants some more. He says, come here, Puppy, but he can't quite stop him fully. The Ice Shards doesn't block him out, but Team Liquid win a fight right outside Secret's base, which is the opportune time for them to push down to Tier 3 and see if they can force a buyback.
Afara, are you kidding me?
Unbelievable.
I cannot believe that he walks away from that with no HP left over, invokes the tornado, even throws down the ice wall behind him, continues to throw down spells for his team. while backpedaling. That was exactly what they needed. Secret, they were able to get it out of their mid laner, but this time Liquid bought as the bait, and they're going to take down the mid tower.
Oh, Matumba, man. Forced to pop the ultimate. The Finger of Death isn't quite up yet for Pyline Dive. They don't have any quick heals, really showcasing the strength of this Veil of Discord on Puppy, but they're going to continue to try and force it here.
Yeah, Matumba Man doesn't want a hard commit for this. He doesn't have the BKB available.
Oh, Pine, not going to be running into that Sunstrike.
He's just going to back out and...
Good
three supports hold.
Yeah, that was such a good read by Secret, managing to hold against that push with only two supports and not forced into a buyback on the Ursa. And they actually can go for Roshan now.
Yeah, Roshan number three is up. The Aegis and the Cheese are available. And Secret might actually have the advantage here just because Matumba Man has to go heal and Liquid have to reset, but Mind Control up at top. He wants to pick off Misery again. Secret, though, they're gathered up. They know about this.
Yeah, they've got the ward set up. That should be clear now to Liquid. Secrets? Is there any items coming in for them soon that can change the game? It doesn't look like it.
I think they don't really need items. They just needed their spells up.
I was just wondering if there was anything that they would stall for before they go for Roshan, but they've only got, at most, 2k on Eternal Envy.
Yeah.
So I think it really is. I think you're right. They should try and force this.
With the Exorcism up, I think he would be fine, but... Liquid, they are going to be hard-pressed to defend this one.
As Vada throws out the Tornado, EMP scouting this out. Eternal Envy doesn't lose any of his mana. And Wei is actually going to commit the Exorcism. Mind Control is pushing out the top lane at the same time, though. Misery has to be careful with this defense. He's going to be jumped on by the Primal Roar. There is no Sunstrike this time around. Meanwhile, back inside the pit, they have picked up the Aegis. Mind Control unable to finish off Misery, but starts threatening those racks, forcing mass TPs, which allows Liquid then to strike. They've actually controlled up Eternal Envy with a beautiful set of Ice Shards. They're going to purge him and just kite him around again. This could be, once again, Eternal Envy in too deep with his Aegis and dies twice in a row.
Yeah, Puppy's stuck on top of this cliff right now. There's nobody that can really help
him. Tornado timing, no opportunity for Eternal Envy to be able to jump back with a Blink Dagger.
Oh, he's
They're
just going to
throw out all their disciples. They've got the disarms. They take him out. Secret. That was beautifully set up by Team Liquid. They knew it's okay if they take Roshan if we could just force Mind Control to get TPs back at that top lane.
Yeah, big pickup for them is Mind Control. Playing the map control game is Secret. They might just lose this first set of Ranger Axe right now as Liquid. They want to force out the buyback from the Ursa, but they have to be careful not to hard commit as there is the Vacuum Winter's Curse combo available still.
Vada, he's got the BKB, so he's going to stay on the front lines here. He pops it now as he pushes back. Wei Han lays down the ice wall, making sure there is no immediate jump from Secret. Eternal Envy running into that one cost them their initiation.
Yeah. The buyback was used. They still lost the key racks here, the melee one. The top one was pressured out as well. Team Secret no longer have an Aegis to fall back on. What happened to the cheese? Did we just have to pop it early in the pit?
Yeah.
I'd imagine so. That's a pretty big loss for them, too.
You're talking about Fada throwing out spells left and right with that axe? Well, Octarine Core is coming in soon for him. He's already shown this sort of rapid-fire spell casting. It's been ultra successful in some of these team fights, and it's about to get worse for Team Secret.
Yeah. Secret right now, they really need their Exorcism to be used at the perfect time. In the first two fights, they fought around it so well, which is what it was able to kind of break the tides. But the last two Exorcisms...
Oh, that could be a game-winning rune. Eternal Envy spots a double damage. Unfortunately, he doesn't have any disable by himself, but... Yeah, he's just gonna go for the tier 1 tower. Yeah, he knows he can backdoor it.
They still have really strong cores on Secret. Like, Secret don't have to really panic. They just can't afford to waste the ghost again.
Mind Control? Oh, does he actually see him? He runs into him now. Pi actually throws out the Hex with a TP out. Nice play. That leaves no time for the Primal Roar to come back.
Yeah, they don't have the Invoker for the Tornado either, as he was still in base.
Because of Glyph, they can get the deny at this top tier 1 tower that Eternal Envy tried to backdoor. But it looks like a quick smoke and a rapid rotation up to that top lane as they want to try and punish whoever's there, which is going to be Mind Control's Beastmaster for the deny.
Yeah, Mind Control immediately going to back himself away as Eternal Envy just jumps in, takes down the tower.
Was that worth the smoke, though?
I don't think so. I think they were hoping to get
out. Whoa, Puta travel in. Fada comes in on the Hawk. Tornado thrown out. Immediately, Winter's curse is laid out as Puppy. That was just a reactive play, as he knew that there was, or at least he thought there was going to be some big reaction from Liquid.
Secret, they can't, again, they couldn't afford to waste this exorcism. With it down, Liquid are just going to play around this area, wait for it, and then immediately go for the fight again.
Very nice play by Fada that spooked Secret like that.
Yeah, Secret have to just immediately get out. They know that they're in no condition to fight offensively, especially with the Winter's Curse expended. And Liquid are going to go for a smoke of their own. They want to get aggressive here with both the big cooldown spells down.
Secret up to the high ground, manning the parapets of defense.
This is going to mean minimum range racks for them.
Yeah. With the Necronomicons, the boars, the wolves, they're chipping away at mid and top every single time they go for a siege.
And there it goes, almost immediately. Eternal Envy is
now
in position.
Now they jump in, actually manage to lock down Puppy, but the turnaround from Pylon dies. The Lion King protects Puppy. The Sunstrike is not going to land due to a force staff. They manage to get the vacuum back in as well. Liquid, are they in too deep for this one? Eternal Envy pops the Aghanim's in rage, and he's actually taken up so much of this damage successfully.
Oh, the Ice Shards!
Man eventually runs down. They are able to get him. The Ice Shards blocking in Eternal Envy. Puppy, he's still floating around with this Ghost Scepter. They might be able to just finish up this fight with a big win over Secret as Weehaw's trapped in once again for the Ice Shards. Ice Wall combination as they lock in Weehaw into a tomb of ice. Liquid win the fight and take a second lane of Brax.
They already commit the buyback from the Death Prophet, but they don't have the one on the one that matters.
This TP ends up right into the face from Puppy, but Tornado, Snowball, he's trying to draw attention. But is there actually going to be an appropriate response? Puppy's almost getting pushed.
Immediately
Mystery, he has to pop the Ghost Scepter to be able to save himself from the cold snap. As Weehaw's going to be slowed down here by the Purifying Flames, once again locked in by the Ice Shards. He's going to be able to have the exorcism though. Liquid have forced that one. They just need to try and escape with minimal losses. Looks like they're going to give up on Jerix. As they pop out that Fool's Promise, still though, the Winter's Curse is controlling up on top of man. They need to be able to blow him up. Vacuum brings him back in, but that max movement speed is too much for them to handle. They can't catch up. And Secret do not get what they needed out of that fight. They forced the exorcism, but all they got out of it was Jerix's Oracle.
Yeah, luckily for them, because of the Tier 2 tower existing at bottom, Liquid couldn't push their advantage into the Mega Creeps. And with the Ursa coming back up soon, Secret, they've got to do something to get aggressive on the map. Weehaw's almost got the BKB, which is going to help his survivability further. But Secret just continue to lose fight after fight. 12k net worth lead built up by Team Liquid. XP finally going in their favor.
The Shiva's about to be here for Misery. It looks like he is actually going to commit and not have buyback. But I think that's fine, right? Darkseer is a full commitment hero with vacuum and wall replica. A buyback may not actually be effective anyway. Plus the Shiva's against all these wolves and various minions of Team Liquid.
Yeah, in the situation that you're in, I think if you're Team Secret, you just say, buy everything. It doesn't matter. If our Ursa doesn't have buyback, it won't matter if you have it.
Oh, mind control. His boots have traveled onto the Hawk. They have the Ice Shards blocking him in. The Sunstrike does land, and Kuro has to wait out this Ghost Scepter. Now they actually have the Cold Embrace as well. Good turnaround here from Team Secret that might just get the free pick up on Kuro. Kuro can't afford to lose this gem. They're actually going to be able to vacuum brought it back in. There goes the False Promise. Kuro turns around, goes for the Disable, but Tumbavant here in force, popping that ultimate as well as the BKB, but he's dodging this fight, not actually attracting himself to any one person.
He's got so many minions on him.
There's so many Necronomicon. He pops the enrage and fight. He wants to be able to kill the melee net ones that are dishing out so much damage, and he is successful, will be able to survive. As Liquid thought they had their initiation with the Invis rune, scouting everything out. They need to get this gem, what the hell?
Yeah, Pylai died. Took a lot longer than they thought he would.
That was his quick Ghost Scepter. That really helped them out there, preventing Walrus Punch from Tusk.
They need to keep this bottom tier 2 tower alive at all costs. Secret, they've done it before. Against Liquid, too.
Mm-hmm.
They don't have the same set of heroes. The Ursa not being as useful as the Slark.
The gem's gonna be pinged down now. And Secret will be able to claim it.
Yeah, Eternal Envy. Walking around the Roche Pit, they have one shot at this to really come back into this game, and it's gonna be centered around this Aegis and Cheese.
See whether or not we're going to have an early Roche or a late Roche. Feels like Team Secret really need an early Roshan.
They have to deal with pushing out the mega creeps or super creeps at top and mid. So they don't have a lot of time for this. The good news for them though is as long as that tier 2 tower stands at bottom, strategically they're always going to be okay. As long as they don't get mega creeped. Like, their team is not well equipped to deal with mega creeps. They don't have an Alk or something that can clear quickly. Ursa does not deal with them very fast either because he has no clearing abilities. Secret, they just continue to bide their time. They've got pretty much everything that they need item-wise. Not going to get a lot bigger than this. Eternal Envy could pick up one more item, but the rest of them have...
Both teams have pretty good vision around the pit. Unfortunately, Kuro's counter ward is not going to be enough for him to actually get that obs ward at the bottom half of the river. You can see how much Team Secret are prioritizing having vision over this fight. Vada throws out the Tornado EMP. The EMP will not land.
They're just trying to make sure that the Ursa's mana is low. Even with the Enrage up, he relies on the overpower to be able to initiate.
Yeah, this is something that you and I have talked about time and time again, where the carry Ursa is very mana dependent and usually requires some mana boots from the supports on his team, but obviously that can't really outdo all the mana bird coming out from double melee Necronomicons.
Yeah, in most games, by the way, for viewers watching, you won't commit this hard to the tier 2. Usually it's just like, okay, if you're only down one set of racks, you'll let it go and then you'll try to take the high ground fight.
Right.
But Secret just can't afford.
Yeah, they can't afford to lose a tier 2 as that would open up the bottom lane of racks. That was a BKB pop by Matumba Man. The Sunstrike's not gonna land. Puppy actually expertly dodges it. And Liquid, are they really still gonna go for this one? They blew their load. I'm not sure if they can actually stick around and fight. Fada has been controlled up. Highlight die. Managed to snag Kuro. They managed to get the False Promise out though. And Kuro will be able to TP back home until Yule Scepter stops him. And that, it will be the sacrificial lamb, it looks like, for Liquid. As they unsuccessfully try to force that fight. They are pushing out the top lane, though. Quick thinking here from Fada, as he knows he doesn't want to give the opening for Secret to be able to take Roshan with a numbers advantage. So instead, they get mind control, and he's down for 90 seconds. Team Secret, they should be able to hold while still getting this Roshan.
If he was able to get the roar off, that should have been a puppy kill. And Pylite Dive might not have been able to hold this by himself, but instead, they get a free mind control and the Aegis and Cheese.
Cheese was eaten by Eternal Envy this time around as he picks up the Aegis immediately. Weeha just didn't have the space for anything.
Yeah, they probably just didn't want to risk it being denied by wolves.
Yeah.
So both supports had to commit to that top. No sentries around that area for them. Still, Secret are holding and they're looking okay. Things are with the base is in shambles, but they're all right.
Most certainly is, and they have yet to claim a single tier 2. So once they do win a fight and have the opportunity to push down mid, they still have some big towers to get through first before they can actually go high ground.
Yeah, that's the thing that's so scary about Team Secret, is that they work so well as a unit in the late game that even with the double racks advantage, Liquid are playing this really carefully. They don't want to give up anything for the next fight.
Puppy successfully guiding his team so far in this late game. But Liquid are going to play a bit more of a backseat, it seems. They don't want to go into an Aegis. They almost have an Abyssal Blade on Matumba Man as well. But he obviously needs a lot more gold. He wants to be able to get that plus. Oh, they actually scattered out Pylite Die. Tornado, Cold Snap, Cold Snap will actually be there to be able to stall him up. Stop that TP out. And a free kill for Liquid.
Yeah, they're gathered around this bottom lane. Secret really don't want to fight without their lion. Highlight Eye has been so useful for them throughout this entire tournament on this lion. And it's
whoa! Quick blink away just in time by Mind Control. Ahead of that Shiva's Guard.
Everybody's got Ghost Scepters on Secret.
The old off-map ward being laid down by Team Secret to scout out the Hawk and any sort of rotations by Beastmaster with the Boots of Travel.
Yeah, that is 4 Ghost Scepters purses on Team Secret, by the way. So kiting is really in their favor. Wee's going to deny this bottom tier 2 tower. And it looks like Envy in the Roche Pit, but he's just going to blink back.
Not really going to do this one. Jesus, Puppy has so much gold.
Yeah. This is actually a really big game for Liquid to win. After what happened in that Eternal Envy Rapier Slark game, with how far ahead they were with double racks,
right?
I think mentally this would just break you. At that point, I think Liquid are going to say, what do you have to do to beat Team Secret?
Mm-hmm.
Double racks does not seem to faze them.
While Team's playing the farming game, that Aegis will be expiring in a couple minutes for Eternal Envy. Will Secret ever have a better opportunity than this to be the ones going on the offensive?
No, I think you want to fight with the Aegis, for sure. They've seen how much Eternal Envy gets kited around. They desperately need to fight around it, but they're still doing okay when it comes to net worth. Like 20k, I think, is kind of undoable, but 8,000 is not that bad.
Yeah, especially considering these super creeps were picked up rather early, and that does limit your net worth. It's pretty impressive how Secret have managed to hold.
It's because they keep clearing out their jungle.
Mm-hmm. Do you think that's something Liquid should be doing better, is controlling the Dire side jungle?
The problem is they have to decide. Yeah. Do you farm in your own jungle, or do you make that move? And Eternal Envy, because of this Aegis, has been farming everywhere.
Bot is a little skittish to go uphill, but he shouldn't be, as he has a clear opening to be able to catch someone here. The Tornado is just barely going to clip Misery, but we do have the TP in from Eternal Envy. Secret may be able to fight this one.
He's isolated out pretty far, though. It might be able to catch somebody out of this.
Bada knows he's too separated. Meanwhile, the Oracle silenced up, and the Ghost Scepter is going to fade soon. He managed to get the disarm up on Eternal Levy. Pulse pops the False Promise. Meanwhile, on the right-hand side, Pylon dies. Instantly gets taken out. The Winter's Curse controls the wolf, but that wolf dies immediately. And Matumba Man, the rest of the team, they're just going straight for the bottom lane. Oh my god, they want to be able to go straight for the Mega Creep. Well, Secret's outside of the base. They get the Primal Roar.
Oh, they can get weak.
Wait, oh, damn it, the Exorcism is down. The buyback will
they
be
take
up.
This so
without
fast.
The Exorcism. Oh my god.
5 seconds for the clip.
They managed to get the Tornado onto Misery. Mega Creep is up. Secret have to win this fight now, here and now, in order to beat back Liquid and go for a defense of their own. But it's not going to be the case, but Matumba Man, he just doesn't care. He pops the DKB, goes straight for the throne, wins the Necronomicon. There it is. GG is the game. The series, rather, evens up 1-1.
Liquid say not today, as they even up the series 1-1. They desperately needed this game to at least show that they could beat Secret. In the previous series, they had all the advantages in the world, and they still weren't even able to take a game against Secret. Great performance by them, as they... I wouldn't want to even say Cruz, they really had a battle for that one.
Absolutely. Both teams just seem to be ramping up as we finally hit our full swing in the grand finals. So our series is tied up 1-1. We go now to the desk for all of our analysts to talk about this game.